My name is Sophia Lacey. I've been living in Des Moines, Iowa, and I'm so excited because I get to move back here to Bentonville, Arkansas. It's been a lifelong dream of mine to own a home, especially here in my hometown.
We also heard this is the same house number as the house that you grew up in. Is
yes,
that right?
So that's yes. What initially drew me in. I have actually known Dave and Jenny for the majority of my life, and they're good family friends with my parents. And ever since, I've gone from students to babysitter to now just good friends.
So honored to be a part of this and to do this for you.
And I'm excited.
I'm super excited that you want to make it a little cottage because it's perfect for that. I think it'll be great.
Yeah.
Okay, awesome. What do you plan to spend on the renovation?
I have $230. I've been saving up, working hard, and so
hopefully that's a good amount.
Yeah.
What I really love about this home is actually the location. It's a great spot for downtown, but this house really hasn't been touched for 30 to 40 years. Right now, the house is super dated. It's really dark. It has a lot of old features. My home style would be more English cottage style. I studied abroad in England and have loved the architecture. And I think of the stone, the welcoming atmosphere, the lovely landscape, anything that just takes you all in and gives you a warm hug.
Every time you posted a picture, I was like, oh my gosh, I love it. It's so pretty. It's beautiful. I was like telling your mom, like, I'm so just so jealous. Okay, sorry, I'll get over it. It's amazing. I'm glad you had that experience. I love that. And we can try to bring some of the elements that you love so much from the English countryside here to Bentonville. Maybe if we put some stone just on the bump outs, and then underneath we have siding, and then of course replace the lighting and kind of have some soft muted colors.
There's a really concerning area inside.
Okay.
Basically all around this fireplace,
ooh.
I feel like the floor has sunk.
Yeah.
Look at it, it goes down.
It's like you walk downhill.
So I want all of this out, because what we're gonna do is we're gonna take that wall, open it up, mm-hmm. and then the fireplace is gonna go right here.
So Jenny? We're taking this out plumb to the ceiling.
Plumb to the ceiling.
Plumb.
Plumb to the ceiling. Like why plumb? Like the fruit?
Nope, that's something you eat.
Oh, okay, got
plum
it.
Means
real,
go
clear,
over
real clear, real clear.
Take out the whole wall, just go through it.
Yeah.
I'm really worried about just that whole floor system, whether it's just the weight of the brick that's been sitting on it, or if we have a bigger issue with some water damage.
All right. What's it look like up there?
It looks dry. Until we can get down here and check this floor, because there's something going on. And I'm hoping it's just the weight.
Yeah.
Hey, Dave, come talk this through with us. Okay, I was thinking of doing gas lanterns on either side of the garage door and then a hanging one in front of the front door.
Okay, so like a gas line is what, $500 a run? So you're 5, 10, 15. I really want to get into this floor and see like how much damage we have to fix before I not blow the budget, but spend the budget on gas line. Because I can run an electrical line for $20.
Yeah, but gas lanterns. She wants the charm of the English countryside, Dave.
No. Your problem out here ain't near what's in here.
Are you serious?
No. Yeah. I've gas lanterns to buy, Tim.
They're gone.
I'm telling you.
Is it an expensive problem? That's the question.
Oh my gosh.
I've never seen it. Have you seen it?
I've never seen this in a crawl space.
Holy cow, babe.
Oh my word.
I now know why all of these floor joists are sagging. They're full of moisture because there is 8 inches of water sitting underneath this house.
It's what's causing this floor to do that.
Yeah, oh, without a doubt.
And that is a lot of water.
Is it an expensive problem? That's the question.
These don't look like they're rotten. I mean, we'll have to get underneath there, but they look like they're
in good shape. Brand new.
Yeah, I'll bet you right there is your leak.
Yeah, hopefully that was just this refrigerator that was leaking, but
that's what it looks
we're
like.
We're gonna have to pull this to find out. There's a lot happening at the Lacey house. We've got this whole crawl space dry. So I know there's not an active leak filling it up, and we fixed some broken floor joists.
It's all dry down there, we're good now.
The new fireplace that will go on the garage wall is underway. And the new roof will ensure there are no more water leaks.
Hi!
Hello!
How are you?
How are you?
I'm good.
This looks amazing.
A little bit different than it used to look.
Feels more like you now.
Yeah, I think 100%.
We replaced everything, starting with the new roof, new siding. We painted, of course, added the stone on these two bump outs to add symmetry. We kind of reconfigured everything. We centered up the front door, got you a new front door.
Yes.
And then, of course, have the gas lanterns, because that feels kind of old world to me. So I feel like they're just really charming and pretty.
I love it.
The new posts, too, of course. We added, beefed, remember the old little
skinny posts? They were like real spindly.
Yes, so we beefed those up. We gave them a little bit more character.
It's so welcoming. I can't wait to see inside. Oh, my goodness.
Enjoy.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my gosh. This is gorgeous. This is amazing.
So you remember the old doorway opening.
Yes.
So we closed this off, and then we were able to, you know, center everything up. Gave that space to your laundry room, so you got extra room there.
Yeah, beautiful.
And then obviously that giant fireplace that was in the way, get that out so it opens everything up.
Yeah, so now this is your focal wall with your fireplace.
I love it.
So I found this, it's an old mantle.
Oh my gosh, I love this.
Okay, we have a little surprise over here.
Oh goodness.
This was your door to the garage. So now you have,
your own
little bar. It's a little built-in. This is just like a fun little space that looks great when it's open, but also when it's closed, then your fireplace is just the feature. We also have new floors, so this flooring is super durable.
That's awesome.
Kitchen.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. This is beautiful. This is so English Cottage. I love it. This is perfect.
What do you think of the color?
I love the color.
Okay, yes.
I'm so nervous. I love the color. I love it.
It feels English countryside to me.
Yes.
And happy.
Yeah.
And muted, of course, but very joyful.
Yeah.
And you have the beadboard as your backsplash, so you kind of have that cottage feel. Got your two lights on either side, so this whole space just feels like it has room to breathe. We have quartz running around the perimeter of the kitchen, and I love the warmth that the butcher block adds as the countertop on the island.
So this wall here, we did take away a lot of cabinets, so we gave it back over here.
Yeah, so we have tons of wall. So we've got plenty of storage. The one thing we were trying to figure out was how to also give you a dining table.
Yes.
It was a big challenge. So Dave created
a This took table. A little doing, but
oh my goodness,
we got you. Your own table that is then built in.
Oh!
That you can sit at, have friends over, relax. And it doesn't take space away from the room.
Yeah, no. It goes blends so well together.
You have more spaces. You want to go check out your room?
Yes. Oh my. Oh, this is beautiful. Oh my goodness. Oh, it's so cozy in here. Yay. I'm never going to leave. This is amazing.
That was her hope.
Perfect spot to do that.
Beautiful. And the bookshelves.
Fills the wall up, but gives you a lot more storage space.
Oh, again, has that old world feel.
Yeah.
And the lights. I kind of wanted everything to feel very cozy and like it's been here for 100 years.
I love it.
Okay.
Go so check out your bathroom.
Okay.
See it. Oh my goodness. Oh, the floor. Oh my gosh, this is beautiful. Oh my gosh, the wallpaper too. Oh, this. Oh, this is gorgeous. This is stunning. Oh, I love it.
And we did the brick on the floor.
I love it.
Because
this.
I love the texture and again, the old world of it.
Oh, I love it.
And I love the beadboard and the wallpaper in here. It just feels so cozy and British.
Perfect. I love it.
Really, we tried to reorient this entire bathroom to take the most advantage of the space. So it is small, but it's very functional and kind of luxurious too, I think.
Yeah.
And then these are your closets. So you have
perfect.
Plenty of closet space. It's all built in, easy access,
perfect.
No wasted space.
It's like a spa.
I know. I love it.
I love it.